What it is, what it ain't, y'all know it's Top Cat 100 going hard in the paint, the Real Feed TV, which you know you're tuned into. Let's go ahead on and get that out the way. Salute to the whole 100 mile man back up in the building again. Salute to everybody. You already know the love is tucking in and giving back. To all my haters, your sister favors Tiny Lister Jr., and your mother's neck and shoulder build is the same as an American Pit Bull Terrier. I'm telling you, the hoe is real diesel, man. Real brolic-like, man. Now go in the corner and go head on and listen to Murphy Lee, man. That's how I'm rocking right now, man. It is what it is, man. I'ma tell y'all one thing about me, bro. Y'all can't never sit here and say that I ain't gonna bring the real like I'm about to bring, man. Because everybody see what's really going on, you know what I'm saying? But a lot of people just don't want to say what's going on. So let me go ahead on and get into what's going on. Now, basically, man, you see what's going on out here in these streets, man. You got Gates, Big General, you know, and he's back out here in BR. You see what I'm saying? Now, what I'm wondering, and I know what y'all wondering about the title is, what's really going on? Is he getting himself into something that is maybe greater than him? Because we already know that the BBGs had friction with Kevin Gates over him doing the first song with Fredo Bang. Now, to me, what I feel like is that, you know, with this man being from, you know, the bottom or whatever, and him doing videos with people from the top, which is Top Boy Gorillaz, TBG, I mean, first of all, is this been happening? You know, he been messing with Boulevard Mail and all that. As you can see, Percy Keith, you know, was messing with Boulevard Mail shortly before Boulevard Mail went in. He was in the Boss Trippin' video. So, you know, with that being said, they got ties to Myrtle Street is what I'm saying. So, with Boulevard quit, you know, cousin, which is Seven Hardaway, you know, actually, you know, being seen with Kevin Gates. I mean, is this going to bring an uproar with Baby Joe? And this is what a lot of people are asking me. And all I can ask is, I mean, well, rather all I can say is, who knows? Because the last time he took it a certain way, you know what I'm saying? His mind was probably in a different place. So we can't sit here and say, rather Baby Joe don't feel some type of way about this or anything like that. What we do know is Fredo Bang got new music with Kevin Gates. And, you know, that right there is saying a lot. Now, Kevin Gates is not the one to choose sides, man. He already said he loved NBA Youngboy, you know. Now, don't take the fact of him and Fredo standing in the hood doing videos together and stuff like that as if Gates chose a side. Gates already told y'all a long time ago that he loved NBA Youngboy and he loved Fredo. So, what's really going on? You see what I'm saying? A lot of the BBG's animosity may come from him being from Carolina Street, the same place Dussel from. You will never know. You see what I'm saying? Now, what I want to get into about Kevin Gates is he did previous, you know, work with the Boulevards. If you look at the Tilted TV interview, you know, if I'm saying it right, you had Boulevard Mail and Sleepy and, you know, Bubba, they was basically, you know, talking about the whole situation with them and Bootsy and about Kevin Gates. You know what I'm saying? And how Kevin Gates kept it real and stuff like that. And they don't know what went on with them and Bootsy's relationship and why they fell out or whatever. So let's stop sitting here acting like that, you know, Kevin Gates is sitting out here choosing sides. He is one of the reasons why NBA Youngboy is signed right now. If I'm not mistaken, didn't he put that word in to get him that deal in Atlantic? I think so. So I don't understand how y'all feel like this man is choosing a side or something like that. Everybody ain't you niggas. You know what I'm saying? All y'all want to do is just choose a side just because it's somebody to choose a side with. You know, that's weak at the end of the day. You don't know none of these niggas personally, bro. You know what I'm saying? Straight up and down. So why is y'all sitting up here taking a side like you niggas is about to get a check cut or something like that? You can tell that niggas who choose sides under 20, under 19 or something, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because any real guy know that TBG doing music with Kevin Gates is doing nothing but helping TBG and it's helping BR as a whole. You got to look at it like that. So I don't look at it as if Baby Joe gonna go off and stuff like that. Baby Joe is on now. More, and he bigger than what he was when he said what he said when Gates first did what he did. So it's two different times. You see what I'm saying? You don't know if that man matured in his head or not. So I don't want to sit here and jump to conclusions and act like that this is such a big thing. Okay, Kevin Gates came back to the hood. He probably always there. He don't broadcast it. For what? You know what I'm saying? We see how the community is when you post your whereabouts and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? So I don't understand what everybody talking about. We know that BBG still got friction with Kevin Gates or whatever. They not seeing eye to eye. And it is what it is. That's what happened with everybody that does music with TBG. They start being phased out by the opposing side, which is right, because I don't know how much influence they got over you to try to get at me. So you'll never know. But I just want people to know this. Kevin Gates always did what he wanted to do, and he's on his new turning leaf as far as with his health and as far as with his mind frame and his sanity. So why is y'all keep on worrying about a nigga doing music with somebody, bro? He's supposed to do music with Fredo. He's supposed to do some music with NBA Youngboy next too, hopefully. You see what I'm saying? If they could get past that. So it ain't nothing they got to do with Kevin Gates per se, man. You know what I'm saying? The only things that he got into as far as Kevin Gates is when, you know, Baby Joe said you ain't no real bottom boy and this and that, and you got your teeth punched out on Tennessee. You know what I'm saying? But this is something that Kevin Gates let people know a long time ago when he said he had a scratch with Lil Denver. You know what I'm saying? Denver, or whatever his name is, you know what I'm saying? He said he had a scratch with him, you know what I mean? Knocked out his tooth, you know what I'm saying? So that's the price you pay when you stand in attention. Something he said. Now, he said that up on the song. So, I mean, and he said it on songs before that. So all of this stuff where people supposed to be exposing Gates, you know what I'm saying? He basically Eminem y'all as and already said it. So it is what it is. So as far as the bottom boys, you know what I'm saying? They got bigger fish to fry right now. You think that they worried about him doing a song with Fredo Bang? No, they're not worried about that, bro. Because they already know that they cool, bro. The damage is already done. So I don't understand what's really going on. Now, Kevin Gates can sometimes be slick, man. Like he was hanging on that sign and he said, yeah, I'm on Carolina Street and stuff like that. And what did he say? Carry on or whatever. So he was being sarcastic. I don't know who he was doing that with. You know what I'm saying? Because Kevin Gates still got a lot of enemies. You see what I'm saying? Whether people know it or not, it's still a lot of people that hate on him. You see what I'm saying? So with that being said, he did the same thing when, you know, Baby Joe said what he said about him, and he had went right to the bottom and went right back to that same spot, you know, Carolina Street. And he said, you know, bring your big fine ass around here. I'ma park, you know, in your driveway. You know what I mean? That be heavy. You feel what I'm talking about? So if y'all read what that means, basically what he's, you know what he talking about, bro. You know what I'm saying? Now, he talk funny, like as far as, you know what I'm saying, saying one thing but meaning another. I know that sound left, you know what I mean? Pause and everything. You know what I'm saying? But that's what he said. And basically what he was saying, if you pull up, he got that iron. You know what I'm saying? You know, big iron or whatever. So that's what I got from that. So every time somebody talk about Gates, somebody says something about Gates, he end up coming to the hood or whatever. So, you know, I don't want people to sit here and get things mixed up like this guy sitting out here taking a side. I don't feel like he's taking a side. He naturally doing whatever he want to do. And when you a man, you going to make your own decisions no matter who get mad, and you ain't got to live for nobody else. See, that's what happens when you live for yourself. And y'all can learn a lot from that. So with that being said, man, I'm out, man. Holler back like X-Lack.